Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father and Savior of the world, hear us as with humble and adoring hearts we remember your seven words of love spoken on this day from the cross. Draw us into closer communion with your Spirit, that the mind which was in you may also be found in us. We remember the loneliness of that loud cry which burst from your overburdened heart while the dread darkness lay upon the land. My God, why have you forsaken me? O Son of God, beloved of the Father, was ever sorrow like your sorrow? You were despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. For our transgressions, you were wounded. For our iniquities, you were bruised. The chastisement of our peace was upon you, and with your stripes we are healed. All we, like sheep, had gone astray. We had turned every one to his own way, and God the Father laid on you the iniquity of us all. In thanksgiving for the depth and breadth of your love for us, we worship and adore your holy name.
Amen.
And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "Ah, you who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." So also the chief priests with the scribes mocked him to one another, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross, that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also reviled him. And when the sixth hour had come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Just stinks to highest heaven. Everything we value is grossly interrupted, and it stinks. A new virus rises, and now we can't even worship together. We are stuck in our homes. Our loved ones are losing their jobs. Our investments, IRAs, and 401ks are vanishing day by day. School is done for the year, as our teachers deal with e-learning, managing parents who can't handle the whole thing, while the children are robbed of their relationships, memories, friends, and significant milestones like prom, athletic competition, and graduation. It just stinks to highest heaven. Sin stinks to highest heaven. Many are crying out today, my God, why have you forsaken me?" A huge portion of the Christian church believes that all this is happening today, all that's going on in our world, is God's retribution upon a godless world that has abandoned God, forsaken God. And now he throws his anger down on us to punish us all. Wake us up and call us to repentance. This is all so misguided and so false, save one aspect. God does call us to repentance. We have sinned, all of us, and fallen short of the glory of God. The wages of sin is death. All this Scripture teaches us. However, that's not all that Scripture teaches us. There is this word in the New Testament. It's not fully understood because it's such a strange word. I doubt that anyone listening to this has ever used it in a sentence, unless you are a theologian. The word is propitiation. Propitiation. Remember that word? It's used in the New Testament 3 times in 2 letters, one by St. Paul and twice by St. John in his first letter. From Romans chapter 3, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation by his blood to be received by faith. This was to show God's righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over former sins." And from St. John, his first letter, "My little children, I'm writing you these things so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world." 1 John chapter 2. And then in 1 John chapter 4, "In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins." Now, this word propitiation means this: Jesus, God's own Son, his only Son, received by his own choice, in perfect obedience to his Father in heaven, the full anger and utter rejection of his Father, your heavenly Father, and mine, bearing the full weight and consequence of all your sin and mine on the cross because of his love for you. He who knew no sin became sin for you, for me, and for the whole world. God, his Father, rejected him, abandoned him, forsook him, alone on a cross, the worst place to be. What I invite you to remember today, amid all this pandemic talk, is that the pandemic of sin was overcome and dealt with finally, fully, and completely through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You can't sugarcoat this. Your sin caused the death of God's only Son. It's because of you, me, and the sin of all the world that he died such a horrible death. The death of Jesus is observed on 2 levels. There is the physical death by crucifixion, where one hangs on a cross and dies. Thousands died that kind of awful and brutal death. Beneath this physical death is another death, the death of sin. This is the death of the Lamb of God, the one without spot or blemish, who takes our sin on himself and takes its condemnation, forsakenness, and punishment for us. It is the death of the servant of God, on whom God lays the iniquities of us all, guilty with all our sin laid upon him. Jesus is cast into that separation from God the Father that is sin's consequence and curse. Jesus is forsaken by God, abandoned and forsaken. He bears our hell for us. Out of that death for sin comes the cry of utter abandonment. My God, why have you forsaken me? He bears it all. Do you give a damn? Does it matter to you? You better, because if it doesn't matter to you, then you're damned already. If you believe and repent of your sin, then you are saved from your sin, and you have the gift of eternal life with God forever. God's gift to you. With faith in Christ, our propitiation, there is now nothing to fear. Evil remains in this life, but it is condemned for eternity. Viruses known and unknown will come and go, but the virus of sin is overcome forever. This is the truth that matters. The stink of sin is overcome by the sweet aroma of our Savior's sacrifice, removing the Father's anger forever. In the love of Jesus for you, you are not forsaken or forgotten. You are loved. Your gracious God in Christ will never, ever let you go. You receive a place by faith in this extravagant gift, the highest gift of heaven.
Show us your mercy, O Lord. Grant us pardon. Grant us remission of our sins.
Have mercy on us.
You came to save the world, but were brought to judgment. When you come again to judge the living and the dead, do not deliver us up with the ungodly.
Have mercy on us.
You hung on the cross, bearing the death due our guilt.
Have mercy on us.
You suffered once for the ungodly, and die no more. Put to death our sins and heal us by the wounds of the cross.
Have mercy on us.
Do not turn your face from us, but remember us with pardon.
Have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus Christ, author and finisher of our faith, you tread the winepress of God's wrath alone. And you were made a curse for us on the accursed tree, forsaken of God. Grant that our faith in you may never know doubt or change. Strengthen us in the sure knowledge and confidence that nothing shall separate us from the love of God in you, and that, though your Father hide his face from us in a little moment of wrath, we may never despair of his loving kindness. For the sake of your bitter agony, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.